So let me guess, you're looking to get one of those lithium batteries for your trolling motor and you're like, whoa, these guys are expensive. So now you're out watching videos, trying to figure out if they are worth it over those cheaper lead acid batteries. Well, I got good news for you. I'm gonna walk you through the differences between the two. We're gonna cover weight, life cycles, charging times, longevity. We're gonna cover cost, the self-discharging rate, as well as the DOD, which is the depth of discharge. So one of the major differences between the lithium iron phosphate deep cycle rechargeable battery and the standard lead acid battery is longevity. The lead acid battery will typically have around 200 to 500 cycles before it needs to be replaced. And it really depends on how deeply it's discharged, also known as the DOD or the depth of discharge. For example, the DOD rating refers to the percentage of the battery's full capacity that you use each time before recharging. So a DOD of 80%, for example, means that you're only using 80% of the battery's capacity in each instant before recharging. So that's why there's such a broad range of cycles, the 200 to 500, because it depends on how much of the battery you discharge. Do you charge it after every outing? Well, your cycles will be more toward the 500 range. Do you fully discharge the battery before charging? Well, you will then have less cycles. Now let's talk about this guy right here, the lithium battery. And this is where this guy shines. On this EnjoyBot battery, you will get up to 5,000 cycles. Now that's pretty significant. So although more expensive than your standard SLA battery, the lifespan can go up to 10 years on this guy, but top out at 3 years on this guy. All right, next let's look at something that's very important to me as a kayak angler. As you see here, I have my P127 behind me, and weight matters. I don't wanna weigh that thing down too much. And so if you're gonna compare a standard lead acid battery to a lithium phosphate iron battery, the weight difference is gonna be pretty significant. So right now, if you were to go to Amazon and pick out 100 amp hour, 12 volt battery, that thing's gonna weigh around 60 pounds. So pretty heavy. Now for comparison, this EnjoyBot Mini weighs in at 22 pounds. That is one third the weight for the same voltage and the same amp hours as the standard lead acid. Come on now. All right, next let's talk about the battery management system, also known as the BMS. Generally speaking, lead acid batteries do not require a BMS, but lithium batteries do. And they have one to protect the cells. Essentially, a BMS is a monitoring system, or essentially it's a guardian, right? It has sensors and controllers and communication interfaces that regulate the parameters of the battery. It's gonna regulate the voltage of the battery's current, the temperature, as well as the charging state. Now let's talk about the self-discharge rate, another nuance to batteries, right? If you don't use them over time, they will discharge energy. And you guessed it, the lead acid batteries will have a higher self-discharge rate than the lithium batteries. Just for fun, lithium will self-discharge at around 1 to 3% a month. Lead acid, 5%. I don't know about you, but this doesn't matter a whole lot for me because I fish a whole heck of a lot more than once a month. But thought it was interesting and I wanted to share. All right, now let's talk about depth of discharge. We spoke about the DOD earlier in the video, but lithium iron phosphate batteries typically have a higher allowable DOD than traditional lead acid batteries. Most lithium batteries can safely discharge up to 80% or even 90% of their total capacity without causing significant damage to the battery. Even though it's allowable, I still wouldn't recommend it, as I personally believe it will degrade the battery faster. For my EnjoyBot 12 volt 100 amp hour, anytime I get down to 20% power, I charge mine. Now this is interesting because the recommended DOD for the lead acid battery is around 50%. Meaning you should not discharge more than half of your available battery capacity to avoid any damage or premature system degradation. So when you're buying a lead acid battery, it's almost like you're buying a half a battery, because if you use more than that, you're actually degrading the battery. So it doesn't make sense to me. This is why these things are so freaking sweet. Now let's talk charging times. Now the reason that lithium batteries have a smaller profile and weigh less is because they have a higher energy density. More energy and a smaller size. Now this has other advantages as well, especially when it comes to charging times. To charge this EnjoyBot is only gonna take you around 2 to 3 hours. With lead acid, you're looking to 5 to 7 hours for a full charge. I really don't like picking that thing up. No, this could matter because you might forget to charge your battery overnight and you're getting ready to go out around noon the next day. Well, if you had a lead acid battery, you're not gonna get a full charge. But if you had a lithium battery, you can have this bad boy charged in 2-3 hours and have a full charge out on the water. So if you ever see an IP65 rating like this EnjoyBot has, it really means that it has a really robust ABS shell. So that's gonna ensure stable and solid internal structure. And with that IP65 rating, it effectively prevents dust from entering and protects against low pressure sprays from any angle, as well as bumps and vibrations during outdoor journeys. All right, now let's talk about cost, because lithium batteries destroy lead acid batteries in just about every other category except for cost. Well, kind of. It all depends on how you calculate it. Let me explain. So if you're looking at upfront costs, this lithium EnjoyBot Mini gonna run you around $299. So the lead acid, which I'm tired of picking it up and down, for the same amp hours and voltage, is gonna run you around $179. So although the lithium battery is gonna cost you more upfront, it's actually gonna be cheaper over the long term because of the cost per cycle. So let's do some quick math. Let's say you get 5,000 cycles out of this lithium EnjoyBot battery. Well, at $299, it's going to run you around 6 cents per cycle. Now, let's say you get a lead acid battery for the $179. That's going to run you at 500 cycles around 34 cents a cycle. So just for fun, to get the longevity of one of these lithium batteries, you would actually need to buy 10 lead acid batteries. So when it comes to longevity, for what you could buy for $300 would cost you $1,700 in lead acid batteries. Kind of crazy to think about, but you gotta love technology. All right, so I run an NK180 on my Bonafide P127, and it's actually a 24-volt system, meaning I could, one, purchase one 24-volt battery, or I can run two 12-volt batteries in series, which I'm gonna show you how to do. So when the batteries are connected in series, the positive terminal of one battery is connected to the negative terminal of another battery, and the voltage adds up while the capacity, the amp hours, remains the same. So the advantages of this is that you get increased voltage. The total voltage across the series connected batteries is the sum of the individual battery voltages. And this is useful when you need to power devices that require a higher voltage, right? The disadvantage is that you only get the same capacity, right? So although you put two 12-volt batteries together, you're gonna get 24-volt. If you put two 100 amp hour batteries together, you're still only gonna get 100 amp hours. All right, to run these in series, you need a connector cable. You're gonna run the negative of one battery like that to the positive of the other battery like that. And now all you gotta do is connect to your trolling motor. So slide it down here, positive over here, negative over here, tighten them up. And now what should happen when I turn on my throttle right here, this will now make this a 24-volt system at 100 amp hours, and it should run my motor. So let me go over here, make sure that works. Moment of truth. Works like a charm. Well, I hope that was helpful in understanding the pros and the cons between lithium and lead acid. If you're interested in EnjoyBot Mini, there is a code Wendell20. If you use it, you get $20 off your order. And if you have a kayak and you really like the NK180, I have an install video on that. You can check that out right there. Thanks for watching, guys. See you.